Good morning, students. I am Dr. Naina Devi, Assistant Professor of Economics, Kakatiya Government College, Hanumkonda. In this video, we will be discussing an interesting topic, that is population and human resource development. Now let me ask you a question. Why should we learn this topic? What is the relevance of this topic? Here, I want to remind you a famous quote in Telugu given by famous writer Gurajada Apparao garu. Desham ante matti kadoi, desham ante manushuloi. A country is not recognized by mere its land or natural resources. Actually, it is made by its people, that is human resources. I am not sure, but more or less, this is the meaning of that quote. Now, this topic is categorized into four parts. They are the theory of demographic transition, growing trends of population in India, birth and death rate in India, and occupational distribution of population in India. In this unit, you will be oriented to learn the basic concepts of demographic transition theory, occupational profile of the population, and also this unit highlights the link between economic development and occupational distribution of a population of a country. Learning outcomes are very essential in teaching learning process. It gives the end product of learning. At the end of this unit, you should be able to understand the concept of the theory of demographic transition and describe the factors affecting the birth and death rate. You can analyze the link between occupational distribution and the economic development. Now we will move on to the next topic, that is the theory of demographic transition. Let me ask you a question. What is the demographic transition, or what does it postulate? Here is the answer. The theory of demographic transition explains the various stages of population growth. According to this theory, every country passes through three stages of demographic transition. These stages are empirically verifiable. It also postulates the various stage sequences of birth and death rates. Dear students, keenly observe the graph. This graph explains you the three stages of population growth. In advanced population studies, there are five stages in demographic transition theory, but in this session, we will concentrate only on three important stages. As it can be seen from the graph, in the first stage, both birth and death rates are very high. Hence, the population remains more or less stable. This situation prevails in most of the underdeveloped countries. Widespread poverty, illiteracy, poor health and sanitation facilities, early age marriages and social beliefs, etc. are the reasons for this situation. Now, we will move on to the next stage, that is second stage. This is very important stage. The second stage of demographic transition is characterized by rapid growth of population. This situation arises because of substantial reduction in the death rate. The improved living standards, food availability, development in health and hygiene sectors bring down the mortality rate. Hence, the mortality rate will be declining, but the birth rate remains high due to the attitudes of the people towards the size of the family. This second stage is known for population explosion. In this situation, population increases at an alarming rate. Now, we will discuss the third stage. In this stage, the death and birth rates quickly drops due to improved living standards in terms of education, health and nutritious food, etc., which increases the life expectancies and reduce diseases. After knowing the theory, a question will crop up in your mind that what is the relevance of demographic transition theory? The theory of demographic transition helps to understand the various phases of population growth. It can be applied to all the economies. Each stage of this transition model represents a country's economic stage. In this video, we have been discussing human resources. Let us know what is human resource. The population of a country is known as human resource. Economists often see population as an obstacle to growth rather than an important factor which will assist the developmental activity. Thus, the study of population and human resources is very essential from the point of view of economic welfare. In the earlier discussion, we have learned the various stages of demographic transition and its relevance. Now we shall discuss the trends in the growth of population in India. As we all know that India is the second largest populous country after China in the world. According to 2011 census of India, the population level touched the highest of 121 crores. The latest estimates shows that the population of India is around 138 crores. Dear student, you might have observed that we are repeatedly using the word the growth of population. What is growth of population? Growth of population is the change in the number of people living in a particular area between two points of time. In India, the first population census was conducted in the year of 1872. Now, keenly observe the following table, which shows the population data from 1901 to 2011. By using this table, we shall discuss the trends in the growth of population. This data also enables us to understand the different stages of demographic transition in India. Let's see. From the table, it can be inferred that the decadal and annual growth rate of population in India are both very high and steadily increasing over the time. From 1901 to 1921, we experienced the first stage of demographic transition. In this period, both birth and death rates were more or less equal during this period. The second stage of demographic transition occurred during the period of 1921 to 1951. In this period, population grew from 25 crores to 36 crores. During the third stage, from 1951 to 1981, the population grew from 361 million to 683 million. Carefully observe the table. The year 1921 is regarded as great dividing year of population in India because both birth rate and death rates were high before 1921. Latter, death rate has been declining more rapidly than birth rate. Now, let us know the reasons for declining mortality rate. Mortality rate or death rate is the number of deaths per thousand population in a given year. Elimination of famines. Besides the famine of 1943, no other serious famine has occurred in this country, although famine-like conditions emerged in 1987 in states of Gujarat, Rajasthan, Haryana, Bihar and Madhya Pradesh. Yet these were effectively combated to cause any serious loss of life. Next one is availability of nutritious food. People are now getting more and more nutritious and balanced diet than before. Government is also paying more attention to it. This has helped in reducing the death rate. The other reasons for declining mortality rate in India are control of epidemics. Epidemics such as plague, smallpox, TB and malaria, which at time used to cause a toll of heavy deaths, now have been effectively controlled. So, the death rate has reduced to a large extent. Medical facilities have increased in different parts of the country. Communicable diseases like diphtheria, tuberculosis and malaria have been properly controlled. The most important factor for declining mortality rate in India is education. Literacy among women is progressing rapidly. Educated women bring up their children with utmost care. This rapidly brings down the infant mortality rate. Dear students, we have discussed the reasons for declining death rate in India. Now, we will discuss the reasons for high birth rate in India. The reasons for high birth rate can be divided into two parts. They are economic factors and social factors. Economic factors are predominance of agriculture, slow urbanization and widespread poverty. Social factors are universality of marriage, early age marriages, joint family system, lack of education, religious and social beliefs. Now, we will discuss them in detail. The first one is predominance of agriculture. In agrarian societies, children have never been considered as economic burden. Thus, we find bigger families in agrarian societies. Next one is poverty. Poor people prefer large families as they consider children as asset. They feel that more children, more earnings. So, poverty is the cause and consequences of high birth rate. The third one is slow urbanization. Census data reveals that fertility rate is lower in cities than in villages because of high cost of living and housing problem. As the urbanization process has been very slow in India, the birth rate remains high. Now, we shall discuss the social factors. In these social factors, the first one is universality of marriage. Marriage is both religious and social necessity in India. Early marriages are common in rural areas. It is believed that early marriage is a significant factor for high birth rate. Next one is joint family system. Joint family system induces the young couple to have children, since taking care of their requirement is not a problem in joint family. Thus, this system encourages the birth rate. The last one is lack of education. Education alone can change the attitudes of the people towards family, marriage, and birth of a child. Especially, female illiteracy is one of the causes of high birth rate in India. Religious and social superstitions also responsible for high birth rate in India. In the earlier units, we have studied the demographic transition theory, growth trends, and reasons for high birth rate and declining death rate. Now we shall discuss another important feature of population, that is occupational distribution of population. The occupational structure of a country explains the division of its population according to different occupations. The famous economist Simon Kuznets says that when the development of a country takes place, the percentage of population engaged in primary sector shifts to industry and service sectors. Broadly, occupations of a country can be of three types. They are primary sector, agriculture, forestry, animal husbandry, fishing, poultry, etc. All activities mentioned above come under this sector. These are all primary activities because they are essential for human existence, and all these activities are carried out with the help of nature. Secondary sector means manufacturing sector. This sector is also known as industrial sector. All manufacturing industries come under this sector. Tertiary sector, all the activities which help the primary and secondary sectors come under this category, like transportation, banking, education, health, insurance, and communication sectors, etc. Some economists try to explain the correlation between occupational distribution of population and economic development. Hansi Singer says that economic development can be achieved by transforming 85% of agriculture development country into a 15% agriculture dependent country, not development, it is dependent. After independence, serious efforts were made by the planners to accelerate the growth process by changing the occupational structure. They believed that development would be achieved by transferring a section of working people from agriculture to secondary and tertiary sectors. The following table shows the occupational distribution of population from 1901 to 2011. The table shows that during the period of 1951 to 1971, the population of workforce engaged in the primary sector remained constant at 72.1%. During the period from 1971 to 2001, people engaged in primary sector decreased from 72% to 48.98%, but it is still high. In advanced countries, the people engaged in primary sector is around 2 to 5% only. Now observe the table. We will discuss the secondary sector. The proportion of workforce engaged in this sector increased from 10.7% to 27.5% during the 1951 to 2011 period. And in tertiary sector, this proportion increases slightly from 17.2% to 23.5% during the same period. Let's move on to the next slide, that is factors responsible for failure of occupational structure. Due to poor implementation of land reforms, a large chunk of land remained as idle resource in the hands of landlords. These reforms could not diffuse the ownership of land among a large number of marginal cultivators. Thus, this unskilled labor force remained as agriculture labor. The facilities provided by government for the upliftment of poor, such as cheaper credit, marketing subsidies, etc., were utilized by rich people only, and poor and marginal farmers could not reap any benefit from these facilities, leading to a failure in their productivity. The development of high capital intensive industries during planning period failed to create employment and thus created no impact on occupational structure of the country. A rapid growth of population also caused stationary state in occupational structure. The above mentioned reasons forced the people to rely on agriculture sector for their income generation. Now, let us summarize the topic. The following animated video presents the bullet points of the topic. Let's see and enjoy. Dear students, I hope that you have enjoyed the video. Now, we shall conclude our session by formative assessment. This lesson is helpful for all the students who are preparing for competitive exams. But more specifically, this lesson is for BA third year students. Thank you.